Hey guys, welcome to Face World Media. I'm really excited about this video today because in this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can use Zoom.us, which is the online conferencing app to teach your Zumba, your dance class, or broadcast you singing live. Basically, what it's really great for is when you need to leverage computer audio. Now, it took me a while to find this solution. I want to give a special shout out to Donnie Costa, who provided a PDF, which I'll include in the description below as well, step-by-step PDF download. However, I'm going to show you in this video step-by-step, screen-by-screen of how I leverage Zoom to be able to transmit music right from my computer of high quality so that someone like myself or someone you know could then live stream and then teach a Zumba class. You don't have to live stream the class. It could just be having a conference or like you're running a meeting with your fellow dancer. So let's get started. Alright guys, let's get started. You're seeing me basically using Zoom already, but before you do that, let me say a few words about Zoom and about this program. Zoom has been around for a long time. Their stock went way up at the beginning of the pandemic, but for clear reasons, they're one of the top online conferencing tools out there. They have a number of options. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to briefly talk about Basic, which is for personal meetings. You can host up to 100 participants and unlimited one-on-one meetings. The only limitation, however, is that 40-minute mark. So for me, that's not super convenient. I often have meetings with clients much longer than that. And for you, if you're a dance instructor, chances are that you might be doing the regular one-hour dance session. So this may or may not be sufficient for you. Now, the next thing over is $14.99, and it basically removes a lot of the constraints, and you can have meetings up to 24 hours. So this is the option I have. I would definitely recommend that you consider this option. In the description below, there's a link directly to this page for you. Now, I'm going to show you by first ending my meeting right here so you can see what I do to actually set up one. Now, when you first log in, this is the option you're presented with once you log in and download the Zoom app. Now, what you want to do is click on the orange button called New Meeting. Click on that. Let me move myself in a bit. So now you're seeing this full screen and just me talking on my own in my office. Now, when you start your meeting, when you start your dance sessions, you don't want to do it for the first time in front of 50 people. So talk to your spouse, your friend, and so you guys can run a quick test. Trust me, it's worth it. So step one, what you want to do is manage participants. So click on this button down here, and I'm going to shrink this window so you can see exactly what I'm doing. Now you can resize this window very easily just by dragging this corner here, right? You can also go full screen by click on this button once you're familiar with all the features. Now, step one is you wanna click on this mute all button. So it says current and new participants will be muted. Click on that. If this is the first time for you to do it, you might get a prompt from your operating system to say, enter your admin password before I do this. Now the reason is when you have 10 or 50 people or 100 people come into your conference, you don't want all their background sounds to come in with them. You don't want to hear their baby screaming, would disrupt the class. That's why most of these webinars and conferences you have seen so far are all with all our participants muted. So now, next is what you want to do is be able to share your computer audio. Now, this is the hidden gem because you don't want to basically have the music travel through your regular computer speaker so that you can hear it and then have to go through like a microphone like this or some sort of a, internal microphone. You want to travel, you want the music to travel directly to your audience and to your participants. Now, it requires some advanced setting, but it's very simple. All you have to do is click on this green button that says share. Most people are very familiar with these features. However, today we're talking about the advanced toggle, this tiny little toggle here that I have ignored for years and years. Under advanced, there's an option called computer sound only. Now, this is super, super key. It's going to transmit the music directly from your Spotify or your iTunes right to your participants' ears. And we have done this. By the way, when you're done, click on the share button here. It confirms the setting. I have done this test with my partner, with my Zumba instructor. The sound is phenomenal. In fact, it's so good. Once you turn up the volume, you're not going to hear that staticky noise. It's going to automatically kind of balance everything. Now, it does require you to have somewhat decent Wi-Fi access. So after you're done with that, one thing to call out is if you want to talk to your participants, you have to make sure that you yourself are not muted. So the option is right here to the lower left-hand corner. So you want to be able to, if you want to mute yourself, when you start dancing, do this. Now, I just hit unmute so that my participants can actually hear me as well. So that's what you want to do. And basically, these are all the key functionalities that you need to pay attention to. And once you run a test with your friend, you know you're ready to go. Okay, so one thing I would like to mention that requires you to kind of think on your feet a bit is triaging what's called video and audio. So what I mean by that is, as you can see in the lower left-hand corner, there are two options here. One button says mute yourself, the other says start or stop video. Now, one thing that you may overlook is this up arrow right here. Let me explain what these two buttons are for. So once you click on the up arrow, you will see that one of them controls microphone, speaker, anything sound related. And this up arrow over here controls anything video related. So let's start with the audio related settings. If you want to, for example, use a speaker from your home, if you have a fancy stereo, where you want to be broadcasting music so that you can hear it too. You will have to come in here and make sure that you select the right speaker. So for example, right now, by default, my computer is using built-in output right from my computer. So if I'm on a phone call with you or if I'm on a Zoom session with you, this is where the sound is coming from. If you have, for example, a USB that you are plugged into your computer to use as an USB speaker, this is where you need to make the setting change. Now, if you're using a fancy speaker called Bose or some other kind, you need to be able to find it. Now, it's not the end of the world. If the names are kind of cryptic, all you have to do is kind of switch back and forth and you're gonna find it. You know, for example, I don't use my default Mac camera. I don't use a FaceTime HD camera, which is built into Mac. Instead, I have an HD Pro webcam by Logitech. That's much, much better. So that's what I'm using. If you have limited bandwidth at home, meaning your Wi-Fi service isn't the premium service, what you can do to ease the situation a little bit is choose video settings. So once I click on video settings, as you can see, it's now selecting here, you can select the camera. But one thing you can pay attention to is this enable HD button, because now you can disable HD. That will make the transfer of your video signals to come through to other people's homes a lot more easily and quickly. Now, really, at the end of the day, the most important thing is to have decent internet service at home. What I would recommend for at-home Wi-Fi service would absolutely be Verizon Fios where I am, which is on the East Coast of the U.S. Originally, for many, many years, we used Comcast, which isn't nearly as good. So definitely consider that. Okay, so you may be wondering, I'm new to this whole internet speed sort of conversation. What can I do to actually find out how fast my at-home Wi-Fi speed is? Now, the website that can easily help you test your Wi-Fi is called speedtest.net, and it's accessible everywhere. So all you have to do is come in, there's nothing to preset, and just click on the go button. So you can see right now, I am very close to the router, and I'm very, as you can see, is doing really, really well. You give it a second, it's gonna first do the download, right? And then now it's gonna show you the upload. Now, both are important. If you are an instructor, you need your upload speed to be very good. Why? Because you're uploading your data while you're dancing to the music to the internet so that people can access that. right? People on the other end, your students can actually access that. So if you're ready to go, here's how you can invite other people to join you in this meeting. This is a button called invite with a little plus sign. Click on that. Or the option here is to enter an email. You can choose your email service to send invitation. My favorite option, especially if you're doing this through social media or you're going to send out an email marketing campaign, I recommend that you consider these two options, which is one, copy the URL directly, or copy the invitation. So I hope you find this video helpful and good luck to your lessons. I'm so glad you're able to do this, especially if you're an influencer, you're a dance teacher, you're an individual creator who is trying to contribute. This means so much to the community to be able to do something creative, fun, and reunite the people during this crisis. So thank you so much for doing that.